Hi, my name is Megan Reinecke, product manager for the analytics feature set in NCentral. And today I'm going to give you a tour of our latest reports and dashboards inside NCentral. And you'll notice that we're using embedded Power BI. We've leveraged the power of Microsoft to bring us data visualizations, which also use the entire ecosystem of Microsoft interactions and components to make this a smooth partner experience. So right now we're looking at a device inventory dashboard. Each one of these widgets is designed to answer a business question of our partners. So here is a list of devices split by their OS, and it's just a device count showing how many different devices are being loaded up within these six customers. And each one of these, you can drill through to take a look at more interesting data and to slice it and filter it in a way that is meaningful. Here, we've been taken to a table where we can look at the asset change on their OS history. And then we can go back and take a look at the rest of the dashboard. Sometimes our dashboards can be a little bit dense. Some of these bands can be kind of small. And so we can use our focus mode, one of the Microsoft interactions I mentioned, and that can blow this up a little bit bigger, and we can read the legends here, and then things become a little bit more easy to interpret. And we can also drill in and drill a little bit further down into the data to sort the data. And then we can come back up. And all of these here are part of that Microsoft ecosystem of tools that I mentioned. And we have slicers for quick and easy ways to take a look at this data. Each one of the dashboards has a tab where we can see new and related information for each one of the dashboards. Each one of these tables you can export. So that little menu there brought up an export this data option. And you can export summarized data into an XLS form if you like. And we also have CSV form available, and you can just export all of the data with the current layout. Sometimes there may be custom questions that our dashboards are not answering, but we have given our partners the ability to customize the dashboards. So you go to copy and edit, create a new dashboard, and then this will allow us the ability to change the dashboards as we need to. So we're going to put this dashboard into edit mode, and I'll show you how to customize these dashboards. So this is devices split by customer and site, count of devices per agent, and you can see at the bottom we have a lot of other types of information, maybe about asset information per device, or per application. But if we wanted to customize this, we would turn this into edit mode. We can select a widget that's already there, and then we can see which data sources it's pulling from. So I can open this up and I can see that this is looking at application publisher, and then the device name itself, and account of the assets, which is down here. But we can add new data to the widgets. We can change the visualization if we like. We can add filters. You can add drill through fields, or you can simply open up the filters and see what we're filtering on. And once you've made your changes, of course, you want to save that and then turn edit mode off. If some of these tabs are not interesting, you can hide them or you can delete them completely. And of course here, you can add a new tab, which is blank, and make your own. So for today, I will turn off edit mode, and now we're back. Each dashboard that you customize is available to the other users in the enterprise, making enterprise sharing and templating very easy. We also have the ability to schedule and send these dashboards. You can send a PDF, you can password protect it, enter the recipient's email address with a title, of course, You can ask if you send a copy to me. And then you can ask this to happen on a repeating basis, starting and ending, and choosing which day of the week. Then the dashboard will be PDF'd and sent to your inbox. I am also going to take a moment to show you our reports. Our executive summary report is the first report we have that is more closer, both in purpose and in visuals, to the report manager reports. So for our on-premise customers in NCentral, this will be more familiar. And our reports are based on month-end summaries for each one of the critical business items that we're reporting on. So you can see a gauge and a table in a very similar way that we would have seen in Report Manager. Each one of these line items has a corresponding tab here, which shows more details for each one. And then it is summarizing all of the scores together. Each one of these columns is only pulled at the end of each month, which is important to keep in mind. And then, of course, you can go back in time if you like as well. And so I'm just flipping the customer names. These reports are purpose-built to be PDF'd and printed. They are fit onto one screen, and they're not as interactive as the widgets we were looking at before, but they're intended to summarize all of the data at a top level, whereas the widgets are intended to be interactive and therefore provide a better digital experience as opposed to a flat print screen experience. For our NCentral partners, it's also relevant to know the difference between things that come with NCentral releases and what's inside Power BI. So inside Power BI is in this white screen, and as we have more data ingested and available, and as we make more reports available, these are simply available to our partners independent of the NCentral release train. Things like schedule and send, copy and edit, and other new pieces of functionality as we build those out, those will be dependent on NCentral releases. So it's important to keep up with the upgrades. But it's nice to have both of those two things in parallel tracks for our analytics partners. And that is a current tour of the availability of functionality, feature sets, and data in our GA product of analytics. We look forward to continuing to add more and build more as partners give us more feedback. Thank you.